Now, I cordially invite Professor Gandhika to introduce our next speaker of the day, Dr. Bimali Weerakoon.
Thank you. It's a pleasure for me to read a short biography about Dr. Bimali Weerakoon. Dr. Bimali Sanjeevani Weerakoon is a senior lecturer at the Department of Radiography, Radiotherapy, Faculty of Allied Health Sciences, University of Peradeniya. She is an alum of the University of Peradeniya Allied Health Sciences, and she has received her PhD in Magnetic Resonance Imaging in 2017 from the Chiba University, Japan. And she has got a scholarship for her PhD from the Japanese government. And she has also obtained a diploma in computer tomography and certificate of proficiency as a radiographer. And she has her research interest in MRI, CT, and also dental radiography and conventional X-ray imaging. Dr. Weerakoon has participated as a resource person in the final accession of CT and MRI training programs for the radiographers, and also she has helped in updating the curriculum in radiography and radiotherapy at the Ministry of Health, Nutrition and Indigenous Health. And she is a member of the panel of reviewers at the International Research Conference of the KBU University, and then she is a member of the International Society of Radiographers and Radiological Technologists, and also a member of the International Society for MRI. Over to you, Dr.
Good afternoon, everybody. First of all, I would like to thank the organizers for inviting me to this event. Second, I'm really happy to deliver this talk in front of one of my teachers. Actually, he was the first teacher in my undergraduate life. Sir, I'm really proud to say that I'm the first PhD holder in the Faculty of Allied Health Sciences, University of Peradeniya, the faculty that you have initiated. So without you, there is no Peradeniya AHS. So thank you very much, sir, for everything you have done for all of us. Yes. Now, move into the today's task. So here I have selected the topic to talk to you all about the impact of artificial intelligence in medical imaging. Before we talk about the impact of artificial intelligence, we should know what is artificial intelligence. When we move into the artificial intelligence, in a simple way that I can describe you all, is the capability of a machine to imitate the intelligent human behavior. Or in another simplest way that I can say, that it is the putting human mind into the computer. So this artificial intelligence has two techniques. One is machine learning, the other one is the deep learning. The machine learning is the algorithm that allows the computer to learn from previous examples. When we come to the deep learning is the thing that algorithm that allows the computers to analyze, identify the feature representation the available data without prior definition by the human experts. When we focus on the top industries getting revolutionized by AI, there are plenty. So I have selected few. As you can see, marketing, agriculture, travel and transportation, as well as the finance. When we come to the healthcare, which all we are in. So the healthcare is another hot topic that the investors like to invest within the AI, within the artificial intelligence system. So the great enthusiasm for and dynamism in the development of artificial systems in healthcare is shown by the increased number of publications on that specific topic. So here, this is the figure that I have taken from the PubMed database. So here it shows the growth of the machine learning keyword usage from 2010 to 2016. As you can see that it demonstrates the pace of the research activity for ML-powered prediction and prevention is currently higher than the research activities associated with these concepts without involving ML. That means that artificial intelligence is much more interested topic in the today's time. So this is the evolutionary trends of number of articles about AI technology for different types of cancer. As you can see, the number of publications from 1996 to 2019, it has tremendously, and the highest number of publications were based on the lung cancers and the breast cancers. So there are different kinds of applications in the healthcare system integrated with the AI. So there are different types of applications are present. So the insights and risk analytics, then imaging diagnostic, drug discovery, as well as the mental health, the research. There are different kinds of research as well as the other applications are present with AI. So when we look at the this point, as we can see here, this is actually heat map. The most red color demonstrates the number of articles. As you can see here, the in between the 2015 to 2016, the imaging and diagnostic field, it has the greater attention. So what are the significance of artificial intelligence in medical imaging? So the biggest problem facing the radiologist in general is the overload of too much information, too much patient's data. So the research, the literature demonstrates approximately 20 million radiology reports contain clinically significant errors. These diagnostic errors play a role in up to 10% of patients' death. Not only that, 2/3 of the world population, that is around 4.7 billion people, they have a lack of adequate access to the radiology facilities. Although the things are like that, radiological imaging data continues to grow at the disproportionate rate when compared with the number of available radiologists. So this force to compensate by increasing the radiologist productivity. Because of that, an average radiologist must interpret one image at every 3 to 4 seconds. In 8-hour workday working hours. So this demonstrates the emergence, this demonstrates the importance of the integration of AI systems into the medical imaging systems to increase the efficacy as well as the efficiency in the healthcare. So So this figure demonstrates the medical imaging system and the population health without integration of AI, that is artificial intelligence systems. What happened is, at the disease of the population, we can identify only at the symptomatic stage. If we incorporate AI systems into the medical imaging field, what will happen is we can identify the disease at the early stage, that means the pre-symptomatic stage. Example, the dementia, we can identify the disease at the pre-symptomatic stage if we incorporate AI systems into the medical imaging field. So this demonstrates the number of publications obtained using the search query of AI and the medical imaging. From 1969 to 2017, we can observe the number of publications have tremendously increased in the all the fields of medical imaging. So when we consider the imaging modality, the MRI has the highest number of publication followed by the computed tomography. So we know now that AI system is already in the healthcare system. The AI system is already in the medical imaging systems. So we should know what is the reason why medical imaging field needs AI. So there is global shortage of the radiologists, and we expect the medical imaging facilities should give us a higher productivity and better diagnostic accuracy and improved patient outcomes. To obtain all those things, we should incorporate AI systems into the medical imaging field. So what actually happens when artificial intelligence in medical imaging? Radiologists visually assess the medical images. They detect, they characterize, and they monitor the diseases depending on their education and experience. So they give the result based on their experience, based on their education. So that is more subjective and more qualitative. But when the AI method is incorporated into the medical imaging system, what will happen? It automatically recognizes the complex pattern in the imaging data, and it gives us the quantitative results rather than the qualitative assessment of the radiographic characteristics. So there are different places that we can put the AI systems. Here, that is a brief explanation. The existing situation is the population is there. They undergo imaging tests, and those imaging data is reporting by the radiologist. They give us whether that is positive or negative. The second stage, that is the triage. The population is there. They undergo imaging tests, and then those imaging data we send into the AI system. That AI system gives it tell us whether that is positive or negative. If there is a positive, again we send the positives to the radiologist. The third one is the replacement. The population is there, then they undergo imaging tests. Those imaging data we completely send into the AI. The AI system alone, it says whether this is positive or negative. The fourth one is the add-on, that is the population is there, they undergo imaging tests, the image data we send it to the radiologist, then the radiologist says whether that is positive or negative. The positives again we send it to the AI, and AI gives the accurate results. So that is like we are getting a second opinion from AI. So these are the different places where we can place AI in the clinical workflow. So when we come to the impact of AI in medical imaging, they serve as a very experienced clinical assistant. It augments the radiologist or the clinical workflow's productivity, accuracy, quantification ability, and the routine tasks. So, then where artificial intelligence will help in medical imaging? So this is a graph that shows where that we can get the help of the AI. As you can see here, except the acquisition stage, processing, interpretation, decision, they all of those stages, the vendors are interested to develop artificial intelligence systems in medical imaging. However, in the acquisition stage also, if we see the literature that we can observe, there are plenty of algorithm has developed to get the images. So when we come to the specifically, the image analysis and interpretation, and the better diagnosis and decision taking, at that stage, we can reduce the human errors. It can expedite the early interventions, more quantitative and more objective diagnosis. And at this stage of the optimizing of practice, that in that stage, we can decrease the patient waiting time, and we can track the primary and the incidental findings. And when we organize the examination, we can get the help of the AI. And not only that, when we come to the results reporting, auto-populated quantitative study results are available. So what we can do is, what radiologists can do is, it can edit. Not only that, the patient care and the safety, the detection and prioritization of the potentially critical results, and treaters the risk assessments, like in cancer, those are the things that, those are the places where we can get the help of the artificial intelligence in medical imaging. So, I have put this slide because it is just an interesting slide. As you can see, the leading disease type considered in the AI literature is the cancer. Followed by the central nervous system problems. So that means we can incorporate the cancer detection with AI systems. And the number of articles with AI stratified by the body parts are the central nervous system, followed by the breast. And that means definitely AI system can impact in the medical imaging field. So how it has benefited? It definitely assists to the radiologist. It can play as an effective clinical tool. It can optimize the workflow and efficiency. It can give a good clinical decision support maker. And it is available 24/7, and it can retain information. And it do not have, the radiologist may have loss of the memory, but in here, the AI system, we do not have such a kind of thing that they are not susceptible to sleep deprivation and short-term memory loss. Not only that, the most important thing is the reproducibility. If we feel something wrong, we can go back to the procedure and we can check the results. So although there are a lot of advantages, although there are a lot of benefits, there are disadvantages too. So because the vendors are different, because of the development of algorithms, are doing by different people, the data consistency is not there. And to perform machine learning technique, they should have a lot of examples. But the
limitation of the sample also a problem.
And
unknowns and uncertainties in medicine we cannot stop.
So what are the potential challenges facing the clinical implementation of AI system?
As in everywhere, the high initial development cost is a problem. Because in Sri Lankan context, most of them are based on the government hospitals. The government gives the funds to run the procedures, run the facilities in the hospital. So it is really hard in Sri Lankan context to implement this kind of AI systems into our government hospitals. Not only that, there are some integration issues as well. The first thing is the ethical issue. I can say a few examples that if machine learning technique has taken a decision, if we feel something wrong there, can radiologist to overrule that decision? We do not have a clear policy state. And not only that, if AI makes a problem, if AI taken a misdiagnosis, who will be responsible? Again, we do not have a specific policy on that. And the reluctance among medical practitioners to adopt it because of it needs IT knowledge or some advanced knowledge. Our conventional radiographers and radiologists, they are reluctant to engage in artificial intelligence systems. Not only that, fear of replacing humans. The radiographers and radiologists, they all have the fear of the replacement of their profession. Because of that, they are reluctant to adapt into the situation. Not only that, the state regulation for the medical devices, as we all know that in Peradeniya, in Mahanagama Cancer Hospital, to install the PET CT scanner, it took long time. Likewise, the state regulation also challenged to this kind of installment. And not only that, lack of curated healthcare data. We do not have the collection of data in Sri Lanka. If we want to do it, we want to do it as a research. Then, after all, will AI replace the radiologist? What do you think? The literature says AI will not be diagnosing the patients. Therefore, it will not replace the radiologist. What they will do is, it will augmenting their ability to find the key data they need to care of a patient. Because of that, AI should help us with our decisions, but the decision always ours. However, although the AI will not replace the radiologist, it will alter the radiologist who is using AI with the radiologist who has not embarrassed with AI. So the radiologist who is using AI definitely replaced the conventional radiologist. Not only that, as allied health professionals, will AI replace the radiographers? Again, there are a lot of automatic processes can be done, like operating the equipment and selecting the imaging parameters and imaging protocol. However, there are a lot of responsibilities that cannot be replaced from a machine or the technology. Escorting the patient into the equipment, explanation about the procedure, explanation the risk of the radiation, and getting the informed consent to the study, and positioning the patient within the equipment. They cannot do through technology or through a system or through an equipment or the machine. Therefore, happily we can say, as radiographers, our job cannot be replaced by a machine. However, again, they may have. So, in a summary, I can say that AI will persistently and pervasively enhance all the aspects of medical imaging field. However, it is not human versus AI. It is the human augmented by AI versus the human working without AI. And AI will expand the today's decision-making capabilities. Earlier and better detection leads to the better treatment options and improved outcomes. Meaningful AI will improve the quality, efficiency, and outcome. So finally, I can say AI is like having an extra set of eyes to provide additional information to healthcare workers for optimal patient care. So thank you very much. And if you need any clarification or if you are interested more, you can read this course reading material. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Weerakoon, for that very informative lecture. I'm sure the audience will be having a lot of questions to direct to you.
Like a trainee, you make mistakes, it's my responsibility.